Hey folks, this is Gazwa Ankari over at SharePointQuester.com. I'm not sure if you've noticed it or not yet with SharePoint 2013, but the sign in as a different user is no longer available. You know, on the top right hand side where it shows you the account logged into the site, one of the options was sign in as a different user. That's no longer the case. I don't know if this is a glitch in the system or not. I hope the SharePoint team puts it back in the product. Personally, as an individual who creates applications for others to use and I need to log in with other credentials to see what they're actually seeing, to me that was a setback, so I hope, unless I read something otherwise, I hope they put it back in the product. In any case, there are a couple of ways you can get around this. One, on the client side, by changing your browser so that you connect with a different user all the time. And the other one would be on the server side, where you can actually bring back that menu to the drop-down menu. So you'll actually be able to see sign in as a different user. So right now, here I am on a SharePoint Quester site. If I go to my system account here and click, I see About Me and Sign Out. So I'll show you how we change that in just a second. So we'll close this. We'll go with the first option. The first option is to basically change your browser so that you're logged in as a different user all the time. Or at least that would be an option. So to do so, I use Internet Explorer. So I'm going to go to my C drive, and I'm going to go to Program Files 86, and I'm going to go to Internet Explorer. And then in here, I'm going to look for iExplorer and drag it and drop it on my desktop. And the first thing I'll do here, this is a shortcut, I'll rename this to IE with my name, Gazwan. And then I will right-click and go to Properties. And then the target destination here, something I want to change. I want to change this to my account. So this line of code will be in the blog post itself. Copy this. This is going to be your target. And we're going to paste it right here. And we're going to say apply. We're going to say OK. So this basically just says run IE as this individual. That's all that this thing does. We're going to double click on this shortcut. And what you're going to notice is a prompt that asks you for your password. Go ahead and enter your password. However, you will not see anything you enter. So be careful and enter your password. Here we go. I'm entering my password right now. And then enter. Opens up the site. Notice it went to the site. I'm going to log in as the account one more time. So you may get prompted one more time for to log in. And then we'll go ahead and log in. And now you see it's no longer a system account. It's Gazwan. So that's one way of doing it, and that's the client side. The other way of doing it is to change or add back that menu item to the SharePoint drop-down menu. For that, you have to be on the SharePoint server, so I logged back into my SharePoint server, and then I'm going to navigate to my C drive, Program Files, Common Files, Microsoft Shared, Web Server Extensions, 15, and then we are looking for Template. And then we're looking for control templates, and then look for your welcome file. We're going to right click on the file. We're going to open it up in edit mode. You can make a copy of it if you like. And then I'm going to grab this code snippet. Let's see which one. Not this one. This is the one I just opened. We're going to copy this code snippet right here, and this will be on the blog post. Copy it. And we're going to look for where it says ID equals to ID request access. We're going to drop the code snippet right here. And we are going to save this file. No need to do anything else. Just save the file. OK. We're going to open up browser. And we are going to refresh. Actually, I probably want to close the browser. So let's open up the browser. If you have it open, I would say close it. And you're going to notice SharePoint tells you it's working on it. Last time I did this, it took about 45 seconds or so for SharePoint to work on it. And then once it comes back, you'll see that the sign-in as a different user is there. So I'm going to pause this until this comes back. Okay, so SharePoint is back. And now you'll see under System Account, we have sign-in as a different user. So we'll select that and we'll say I'm going to sign in as Gazwan. And then password, and then click OK. And now we're signed in as Gazwan. Now, of course, this is not out in out of the box, so I would definitely say this is at your own risk. I would definitely put this on my test environment, my dev environment, maybe wherever I test as well. but I don't know if I'm going to put this on production or not. I don't think there is a reason for us to put this on production. But in any case, this is at your own risk. This concludes this video. Hopefully this was helpful. This is like the first thing I saw. You log in and I'm like, I want to test with some other account and oops, I don't see it. So hopefully this was helpful for you guys to see. Thanks for tuning in.